China retaliates in the escalating trade war. I'm Hillary Lane with more on the impact it'll have on everyday Americans, in particular farmers.
And Montana Governor Steve Bullock says he's running for president. Coming up, an exclusive report on why the governor says he is running for the highest office in the land.
Bozeman-Gallatin High School's new mascot and new school colors could be named tonight.
Good morning to you, 6:30 here on this Tuesday morning. I'm Missy O'Malley with Chet Lehman. Matt Elwell has our kind of wet week of forecast here in just a few minutes. We'll get to that a little bit later. China hit back in the trade war yesterday, announcing tariffs on $60 billion worth of American-made goods.
The move came only a few days after President Trump hiked tariffs to 25% on $200 billion of Chinese imports. And CBS's Hillary Lane reports the president now looking to up the ante yet again.
The trade war with China took its toll yesterday, sending stocks into their worst one-day slide since early January.
We're doing really well as a country.
Last night, President Trump said he's confident it'll work out.
We'll let you know in about 3 or 4 weeks whether or not it was successful. You never really know, right? But I have a feeling it's going to be very successful.
Earlier in the day, he suggested placing more tariffs on Chinese imports.
We have the right to do another $325 billion at 25% in additional tariffs.
These would hit essentially all products not currently covered by the existing tariffs. China's top diplomat remained optimistic, insisting both countries' negotiating teams have the ability and wisdom to resolve each other's reasonable demands.
We love our farmers. We take care of our farmers.
Meanwhile, the president is promising to subsidize farmers targeted by Chinese tariffs,
which is about $15 billion. And do something reciprocal to our farmers.
Though many say they'd rather get back to business as usual.
We don't want to see trade aid packages.
Michigan farmer Dan Keenan says soybeans have been hit the hardest. Prices are at a 10-year low.
You try to sharpen your pencil and tighten your belt, your pencil can only get so sharp, and we try to tighten our belts any further and we start losing circulation in our legs.
Keenan hopes the two sides can find common ground to end the standoff quickly. Hillary Lane, CBS News.
Now, President Trump does say he will meet with Chinese President Xi at the G20 summit, which is about 7 weeks from now.
And our top story for you out of the state, Governor Steve Bullock is off and running this morning for President of the United States.
MTN's Mike Dennison, who reported 2 weeks ago that Bullock planned to launch a presidential bid, has the details on Bullock's official announcement and the Democrats' fledgling campaign for the highest office in the land.
Governor Bullock officially launched his presidential bid at 4 a.m. Mountain Time, releasing a 2-minute, 44-second video that outlines his campaign themes and a declaration of his candidacy.
I'm Steve Bullock, and I'm running for president. With your help, we will take our democracy back.
The video focuses on Bullock's fight against corporate and dark money in campaigns, referencing the notorious past political power of Montana's Copper Kings, and says he'll fight against what he calls a corrupt system.
That's why we need to defeat Donald Trump in 2020. And defeat the corrupt system that lets campaign money drown out the people's voice, so we can finally make good on the promise of a fair shot for everyone.
It also notes his re-election victory in a state won by Trump in 2016 and his progressive policy victories on Medicaid expansion and education spending. Bullock's also planning an event later today at Helena High School, where national media will be on hand to film his encounter with students in a classroom. But once today's launch publicity subsides, Bullock has a steep hill to climb to become relevant in the presidential contest. He's the 22nd Democrat to get in the race, and observers say he'll be competing against far more experienced political hands and fundraisers. Yet he's not without some experienced hands of his own. The Hill, a D.C. publication, reported Monday that one of his top advisors worked for the presidential campaigns of Al Gore and John Edwards, and that he's being advised by Jennifer Palmieri, a director of communications for the Obama White House. He also has staffers on the ground in Iowa, site of the nation's first presidential nominating caucus next February. Bullock is being mentioned in some Democratic presidential primary polls. In an online poll completed last week by a national firm, Bullock, along with several other candidates, registered at 1%. Reporting from Helena, Mike Dennison, MTN News.
Now, MTN will have more coverage later today on Governor Bullock's presidential campaign launch.
Much more to follow on all of the candidates in that race. Matt joins us now today. I'm going to really focus on today before we get to the rest of the week.
Yeah, if I was going to run for office, I'm running on today's forecast, not later in the week. This is all I'm saying. The temperature's into the 40s today. Everybody loves me when it's going to be in the mid-70s and plenty of sunshine. Later this week, we are talking, there's a glimpse, oh, showers. I just lost my campaign. We'll talk more about your complete forecast, of course, coming up in just a few minutes.
Oh, I don't need to be in that cabinet anytime soon, but hey, I appreciate all the effort. Thank you for that, Matt. Now, here's our top local story, and this has been a story that we've been following for quite some time. There were some tense moments at the Bozeman High School parking lot yesterday as police officers were seen with their guns drawn.
A statement from the school district says it happened about 1:20 p.m. the senior lot along West Main when Bozeman police officers tried to stop a stolen vehicle. School district says it all happened very quickly, but no one was hurt. Suspect was arrested without incident. But there were a few students in the parking lot at the time and this all went down. District says because it happened so fast, because there was not an immediate security threat, the high school was not locked down. No security in place was ordered. Classes did in fact remain in session.
And here's another kind of tense one that people have been following. This is what I meant to say. Last night, the Bozeman School Board finally tackled the issue of colors and the mascot for the new high school.
MTN's Cody Boyer was there for the final vote and has our report.
We're happy that they can have a fun mascot to always attach to.
A lengthy process that came to a 7-1 vote across the Bozeman Public School Board. Superintendent Rob Watson opened the floor with a community poll, which compiled over 2,700 votes from students, parents, staff, and other community members. The numbers were there. Raptors led the Mountaineers by 17 votes. In the end, Watson recommended that Raptors, as in the dinosaur, would be the favorable option.
We do believe it will be easy to brand. Branding will be important.
Mountaineers were a close second. One man, Jeff Krogstad, argued that the Mountaineers spoke more for local military history.
We can find a lot more living history right here in the Mountain Valley based on the Mountaineers.
But the loud voice came from Laszlo Baumgartner and his dad, Scott. While they say their first choice didn't make the top five, Laszlo says future Raptors like him thought the prehistoric predator was more fun.
I really want to have a mascot that like everyone can be supportive of, and it's really fun because like the first couple of years it's going to be building for us as a school.
Laszlo and his sister even were given some of the first school shirts donned in the new school colors, which won by a landslide, black and royal blue.
I'm just proud of Laszlo getting up and talking to the trustees, and
I'm happy. I mean, this is kind of one of the things I really wanted.
In Bozeman, Cody Boyer, MTN News.
Now Cody tells us the mascot design's still being discussed.
Bright young man.
Yeah.
And a Bozeman man could face up to 100 years in prison after investigators say he raped a teenage girl. 20-year-old Stephen Allen Myers appeared in Gallatin County Justice Court, charged with having sex without consent involving a 13-year-old girl at the time of the report back in January of 2018. According to court documents, Myers told detectives he dated the girl for 3 months and admitted to sexual contact with the victim during that time. Myers could face up to life in prison since he was 4 or more years older than the victim while she was a minor. His bail was set at $10,000.
Police in Butte have released the identification of a motorcyclist killed in Friday's hit-and-run crash as 41-year-old Benjamin Harrison. Harrison was killed near the intersection of Dewey Boulevard and Lexington Avenue just before 2 o'clock in the morning on Friday after he was struck by a hit-and-run driver. Police also identified the driver of the other vehicle as 41-year-old Marcus Sepulveda, also of Butte. Sepulveda was found dead in Anaconda Deer Lodge County on Sunday.
You know, we're not really sure what the individuals were thinking at the time of the incident, the actual crash. It's a tragedy for our entire community, and it's just one of those incidents that there's really not a lot of rhyme or reason, and it's just extremely unfortunate.
Sheriff says it may take about 3 weeks to complete the investigation into that incident.
It is 6:39. It's time for a quick break. Let's take a look ahead on Montana This Morning, as well as your headlines coming up at 7 on CBS This Morning.